Now here's a look at some corporate stories, starting with the new share sale program of the renewable energy arm of the Ayala Corporation, ASEN. Now the company files for shelf registration with the Securities and Exchange Commission for the offer of up to 50 million preferred shares. Now the first tranche is for 12.5 million preferred shares with an oversubscription of another 12.5 million shares at an offer price of 1,000 pesos each. Now this means the first tranche could fetch as much as 25 billion pesos for ASEN. Meanwhile, construction company Megawide narrows its quarterly attributable net loss on the back of revenue growth. The 7.12 million pesos is lower than the 60 million pesos a year ago. Megawide reported Tuesday its first quarter revenues grew by 11% to 4.36 billion pesos. And finally, cement manufacturer Holcim inks a deal with a Singapore-based concrete producer, Sungshin Cement. Holcim's memorandum of understanding with Sungshin will have the former serving as the priority supplier of cement and aggregates for Sungshin's ready-mix concrete batching plants. The deal came after Manila and Seoul agreed on a $3 billion funding in loans to support the Philippines' infrastructure and green projects. And speaking of banks, HSBC sees great opportunities for investment and expansion in the Philippines and in ASEAN as a whole. Amanda Murphy, HSBC's head of commercial banking for South and Southeast Asia, said the whole region is an attractive market for the banking sector. She cites several factors, including the Philippines' highly educated workforce and a high level of digitalization.
I think this is the most exciting region to be in. And I've worked in the UK, the Middle East, North America, and in Asia a few times. And this, I think it's the time now. If I look at ASEAN, look at Asia, our time really is now, whether it's India, Bangladesh, into Indonesia, the growth that we're seeing there, Malaysia, Singapore as a regional treasury center, over here to Manila, to the Philippines, to Vietnam. All of those countries are seeing great, strong double-digit growth with lots of opportunity to come. In the Philippines, we see an increasing growing consumer class. We think that will just continue as the years go on. There's a need for more support. There's a need for more investment. So we're most definitely in. And we're most definitely committed to hopefully the next 148 and a half years here in the Philippines.
Bank loans to MSMEs reached 263 billion pesos in 2022. The Philippine Central Bank says that amount was near 16% of the total required reserves. It adds banks lent nearly 73 billion pesos in loans to eligible large enterprises as alternative compliance. The central bank in 2020 allowed MSME loans to be part of banks' reserve requirement in an attempt to boost lending to the sector amid the COVID pandemic. Malaysia's first tourism sales mission in the Philippines kicks off. The sales mission in Manila and Davao began on May 20 and will last until the 28th. Kuala Lumpur is seeking to lure more Filipino tourists to visit the country. Aside from leisure and shopping, the events also highlight niche segments like healthcare and medical tourism, as well as educational tourism. Over 159,000 tourists from the Philippines visited Malaysia last year, being the top 10 source market for international arrivals. There are over 60 flights per week from Manila to Kuala Lumpur via Malaysia Airlines, Philippine Airlines, Air Asia, and Cebu Pacific.